Namaskaram. Is English or Tamil which is preferable? Okay, I'll try to keep it as a mix because you have people from all. So the topic for the day is Surya Vaibhavam. I think most of you know the auspiciousness of the day today. Today is Ratha Saptami. So the focus of the deity today is Surya Deva. Let's start a bit from the beginning. So our dharma, as most of you know, is called as not Hindu dharma. It is called as Sanatana dharma. Or it is also known as Vaidika dharma because it is based on the Vedas. This dharma has got four objectives for human life. These are called as purusharthas. Dharma, artha, kama and moksha. Dharma is to lead life the right way. Do the right things. Artha is to earn whatever you want in the right way. Kama is to satisfy your desires, but in the right way. And moksha is ultimately when you are fed up of all this, then you are looking for liberation. So, artha and kama everybody understands. Everybody is behind it also. But the beauty of Sanatana Dharma is artha and kama has been kept inside dharma and moksha. Without dharma, there is no artha. Without dharma, there is no kama. If it is artha and kama without dharma, then it doesn't come under Sanatana Dharma. So dharma is the basis, is the moolam for all the other satisfying the objectives. Now for satisfying these objectives, many times we ourselves are not capable of doing them on our own. Hence we seek help outside. When we seek help from other people, we call it friendship, or we call it charity, or we call it help in the normal terms. But when you seek help from some divine source, from some power which is beyond human power, that is when the concept of a god or a deity comes in. In Sanatana Dharma, we don't have a concept of a god. We only have Devata. Devata means anybody who is shining. Deva comes from the root Deepyamana, Divyamana, that is to shine. Somebody who is lustrous and shining means not physically shining necessarily, one who is excellent, beyond normal levels, who is much beyond the normal levels, he is called a Devata. From the concept of a Devata came the concept of gods, different gods that we have today. Right from the Vedic times, we have had Devatas. We have had Vedic deities. Vedic deities, the primary Vedic deity has been Indra. If you look at the Rig Veda, majority of the rituals or the verses are towards Indra. Then second is Agni. And then you have many other Devatas like Varuna, Vayu, Mitra. Among all these Devatas, even then, even during the Vedic times, one of the primary deity was Surya. He was called by different names. He was called as Savita, Surya, Mitra, Pushan. These are the different names, Ushas. Different aspects of sun was worshipped in the Vedic times. Now, sun worship is not very unique only to our culture. If you look at cultures all over the world, sun worship is a very prominent aspect of all worships. In Egyptian traditions, you had the Ra or the Atom, or the Ra Atom, you had that kind of worship of the sun. The Greek, they called him Apollo. You had the sun god as Apollo. The Germans called him as Sol. The Armenians called him as Ara. The Aztecs called him as Prutontia. And we called him by different names like Surya, Aditya and so on. So sun worship is very, very common to all humanity. Because, see, we have the concept of deity, okay? And we also chant when you, most common shloka of Ganesha is what? Vakratunda Mahakaya Surya Koti Samaprabha Nirvigram Kurume Deva Sarvakaryeshu Sarvata. Have you ever seen Koti Surya? We are not able to bear one Surya. That itself is difficult. So Koti Surya is what? It is an imagination. The only light, maximum extent of light that you can visualize is the sun. There is no power beyond the sun that you can visualize in terms of shining. The maximum anybody can shine is as much as the sun can shine. So he is the most visible devata to you. Irrespective of your caste, irrespective of your religion, whether you believe him or you don't believe in him, he is going to be there. He is the only visible devata who is shining. Going by the term devata as shining, the only person, only thing you can see shining is the sun. Everything else shines through the sun. There is also the, every deity actually, to give the importance of the deity, you always call the deity as shining with hundreds of suns, thousands of suns, crores of suns. This is always an upama, a comparison you give to pull up the strength of your deity, to say that, see, this is one sun, but thousand suns is the power of my deity or my god. Dikshitar in the Kriti of, when he is praising Tirumala Balaji, he says, Devesha Pujita Bhagavantam Dinakara Koti Prakashavantam. Dinakara Koti Prakashavantam. One Dinakara is what we are seeing, but he is saying, Venkateshwara is Dinakara Koti Prakashavantam. So this has been a common style, shaili, adopted by all the poets, saints and sages to speak about the brilliance of the devata. So with this as the background, we go into this devata of Surya, who can only be the most visible devata that we know, logically we can explain or see, is only Surya. So we are now going to go the next 60 to 70 minutes, we'll just look into this devata a bit more and the importance of Ratha Saptami today. Now if you look at the different devatas, as I said, in Vedas you had different devatas, but over time many of these devatas began to change. Like Indra was a major deity in the Vedas, but today do you see anybody worshipping Indra in a temple? Hardly anything. There is probably in India you don't find even anybody who is following the worship of Indra also. Varuna was a major deity in the Vedas. But today you don't have Varuna as a deity in any temple who is worshipped like a Shiva or a Vishnu is worshipped. So many of the original deities have changed. You had Vishnu in Vedas, but Vishnu was a small deity. But then Vishnu emerged to be a primary deity in the modern times. So gods have been changing. But among all this, one thing that has remained constant is the cult of Surya. Majorly, if you look at the Indian culture, there are about six traditions we find in the Indian culture in terms of deities. One is worshipping Shiva. It is called Shaivism, Shaivam. Second is worshipping Vishnu, Vaishnavism. These are the two major cults. Then you have worshipping Shakti. That is the Shakta. Ganapati, Ganapatyam. Muruga, Skandava or Kaumara. And the sixth cult is Shauram, the worship of Surya. That is a separate cult, a separate tradition in itself. So this Shaura Parampara has been there right from the Vedic ages. You find the evidence or you find the following unbroken tradition of the Shaura Parampara. This is why also when you look at the Tyagaraja, when he speaks about Gita Arthamo in that Skriti, where he tells Hanuman that you know everything, you know music, you know the essence of Gita, in the Charanam he says, you are the one who knows the essence of the primary traditions of this culture. Which are those primary traditions? He says, Hare Har Bhaskara Kalade Karmamo. Hari Hara Bhaskara Kaladi Karmamo. Karmamulano Marmamulu. Irinkina. You know the marmam. You know the essence of the major traditions which are of Hari, which are of Hara, which are of Bhaskara. So after Hari and Hara, Tyagaraja Swami places Bhaskara. That means the Bhaskara tradition, the tradition of Surya, has been a very, very strong tradition in our culture.